It is 6:30, so, let me...
He was aware of the meeting, right?
We made it when we were sitting here. We were all together at the last Monday's meeting.
Last Monday meeting.
John knows that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am here.
Does that mean something?
So I will entertain a motion...
Are you the lowest common denominator?
I'll entertain a motion to, recess the Board of Selectmen's meeting until later on this evening at the end of the CIP meeting.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Does somebody want to open the CIP meeting?
I'll make a motion that we open the CIP meeting.
John, you're inside this one.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Chris, you the note taker tonight?
We're recording.
Okay.
Yep.
Somebody will be the note taker.
No, it's hard to...
Should we all at once? Thank you, Don.
Thank you, Don.
So,
If you ever saw my minutes, you would say, "Thank you, Don."
Yeah, really. I don't like taking minutes. We have the, CIP with our, and over, we had homework over the week where we each went through on our own and prioritized the CIP requests from each of the departments, the town departments. And we have, I think we'll take them one by one. If anybody has a better plan, let me know. The police cruiser, $25,000, for 2016, and then $25,000 for 2017, and on and on. John was a two, Donna was a two, Mark was a one, Mary was a one, and Gene didn't send in his, even his choices.
He must be sick or something. Nobody's heard from him.
Okay. So this is gonna be a little tougher, because we're tied 2-2.
I mean, I said two just because in my mind is urgent is we cannot live without it. We have to have it, as it, as the description says here.
Yeah, well, to me, the piece of that cut me over to one is needed for health and safety.
Yeah.
That's what it says. One is needed for health and safety. And so I was like, oh, okay.
The reason why I put two is because of the fact that we have the cruisers with us. This right here is an operating budget for the fact of when they go to purchase the new one, which could be, if they didn't need one to purchase them, they could purchase it next year. Mm-hmm. And we're still allocating the money for them to do that so that it didn't fall under urgent because
they have the money?
And because we have cruisers now,
right,
that are,
that, that's
that are fully
how
operational,
that's how
working. It's not like one is just, you know, they're down one because...
Yeah.
A car crash or something. You know,
well, they are.
Well, interesting you should say that.
Now they are.
Okay. No. At the time, I didn't know, so...
No, he's prophetic.
But that was my same thinking. This is, I mean, it's consistent with, you know, the cycle, the purchase cycle.
Yeah.
Right? But...
Well, we've had questions on the purchase cycle.
If we had to forego it and live without it, we could.
I don't mind going with a two on that.
No, I think two's fine.
Well, I would stay with one because I think the purchase cycle has, you know, we started that purchase cycle many moons ago and it's worked. I'm going to stay with the one, but you guys beat me out. You changed to a two, Mark?
Yeah, you know, it what I don't like about the one, two, and three, here, what I don't like about it. Mm-hmm. One says, okay, we need it immediately. Mm-hmm. Two then says, we need it within 3 years. And it's like, well, if you're gonna replace a cruiser, you're not gonna wait 3 years to replace
exactly.
it.
Exactly. So it would have to be a
and
one.
Then desirable is needed within 4 to 6 years to improve quality. It's kind of there's too many
too close.
There's too many variables in those statements for
yeah,
me.
It is.
You know, and that's kind of why I was like, okay, well, you know, he's got one. He's got to get replaced.
I think that's why it makes it a one. The way this is drawn up right now, with the
but we could live without getting a new,
but not for 3 years.
Well, it says within 3 years.
It says within,
so
it
could be
two.
A 2 year person.
Right.
It could be.
Okay.
Yeah. I get, okay. Within. Okay.
Yep.
All right. So I don't.
I'm not gonna. I'm staying with my one. But you guys are all twos now.
Yeah. I was
okay.
Two.
Yeah.
Since I'm the lone man out on the quint, I'll just step out. That wasn't a up or down, thumbs up or down on the quint. It was just saying in the same vein, we have trucks, we have engine 3 that we believe has some life left in it. That purchase could be delayed
a year if we needed it to be.
And so that's why I went with two instead of one.
So I originally went with two on that, believe it or not. I went with two on that. And then I went back to the 1, 2, 3, 4, and one says needed for health and safety. And then I thought, well, I thought that the chief made a compelling argument that his team is at risk anytime they gotta get about a roof.
I probably,
that's why it went to a one for me.
I probably went with a, started off probably at a three, but the presentation really cleared it up for me as to what the benefits of it was.
Yeah.
And I have to agree with the chief that with the metal roofs that are being popular now and the
solar panels
and the fact that they have to vent the attic or there could be an explosion, I mean, that ended it for me.
I agree with all of that, and I'm not saying I'm against the quint, I'm just saying, from the perspective of the CIP, does it make a difference, how much of a difference does it make this year versus next year?
Well,
and then it becomes an interpretation of the ones and twos, and that's where I'm like,
Well, I mean, let's ask Chris, because three people put down ones and I put down a two, and then Chris is proposing a two, so.
I don't get a vote.
Who is proposing a two? Oh, I see.
I was using the same methodology that Donna was about urgency, and
I guess I was using the urgency thing, and I could see that it was, you know, a year is a potential loss of life. That's where I saw it.
Well, I mean, it's 3-1, so if you guys want to go with the one, I'm fine with that.
Okay, thank you, Donna. Next is the ambulance, and that was the same kind of argument, that it's going to be, it's not next year, it's a year down the road.
But again, the ranking was supposed to be for this year, so since it's not in this year's budget, it's in next year's budget, how could it be a one?
Yeah.
Oh,
it has to be
I was thinking about it from the perspective of in the year that it's coming up.
That's how I was doing it.
And that's
is that way that we were supposed to be doing it?
That was how I answered Donna's question, but we never collectively talked about it.
You answered Donna's question that we should do it in the year that it's supposed to get purchased.
No, you said all from this year. From the
perspective
this year,
of this year?
This year perspective.
See, I didn't look at it that way.
Unless
how
I
should
thought.
We be doing it?
Well, you're stuck, and you have these definitions here in front of you that say two things.
Yeah.
One has a timeline, and one has a relative value. So,
can you take an action item to clean up these descriptions?
make them all fives.
So we're tied at two and two. It has to do with our interpretation, I think, of what year we're working in.
The reason I put the ambulance as a one, and I, you know, I can back off to a two, that's fine. But the reason I put it as a one is it is in the cycle when the ambulance is replaced, and it's fully funded by the fund that's set aside for it. Mm-hmm. So it's not going to be a budget hitting item, and and so there's no reason not to do it next year, given that it is a health and safety thing. And in fact, it's probably the most important one of the most important health and safety things that we have. So. That's why it was a...
I think the cruisers are, too.
Hmm?
I think the cruisers are, too. But does anybody want to change
before we
take a vote?
I can go to two. I don't care. Whatever.
John, you still stuck on two?
Again,
okay.
How I did this was on, I don't think anything is urgent because nothing's... So that's why you barely see me put a one on anything because I didn't feel like anything's absolute dire need except for maybe that if they decide to vote for the quint in order to getting that, just because if it's a year from now or 2 years from now, it is what it is.
Because
everything's kind of, I mean, for what we're doing is just setting a projective of what we think. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of these items might, you know, have to come in front of the town to when we go purchase it, and that can change from, we might say one, the budget committee might turn around later and say no, and then when it goes to election, you know, I mean, the town for voting, didn't matter if we put one or nothing. The town didn't want it. It's not
going to
go.
I put one on these health and safety ish items because we have a program where we're replacing them, you know, and we've worked on the program for a number of years. And
right, I always,
if we were in a crisis, we could stop the purchase. None of this is like, God, we have to have it now. because we've got, we've had a program that is working. So that's why, and these have been in the pipeline and well thought out, and so unless something terrible happens, like a crash of the stock market.
There's always different ways of interpreting everything that's on here. We already described that in the past couple minutes, we're just talking about it.
Yeah.
But when, for me, when I see this and this gets printed in the town book, you know, and people see it, they're gonna, when you put one and they read on the bottom, urgent, that sets up a mindset to saying, whoa, why is this urgent?
Mm-hmm.
Why do we need it?
Mm-hmm.
Why is it right
away? Maybe those definitions.
Without having to really know that, okay, it's really not urgent, were you thinking this way, is to put it in a category of, does the town and what we need to, do we need to buy this in order, right now, in order to keep things moving?
Mm-hmm.
We could probably not buy another piece of equipment in town for probably 3 years if we had to, because we've kept everything.
Again, that's why I put twos and threes on everything, but that's just how I interpret it when I was putting my numbers down.
So let's make make the ambulance two.
Because I know they have the money to pay for it, so it's a matter of they're going to...
No, we're I think...
And it's not like the we don't have an ambulance in town, it's just getting the new one that's going to be more up to specs for...
Yeah. They get, they constantly change. Okay, so the ambulance is
two. I changed to two.
Yep.
So the SCBA is that in 2018 has to be a one because it's by law that they have to be changed.
Yes, if you're looking at it from that perspective, then yes.
So you're a one there, Mark.
If that's the perspective we're looking at, if the perspective is it going to be urgent in it in the year that it's here?
Yeah.
Then I would change to one.
Okay.
But again, that's not how I thought we were doing it.
Okay. How are you feeling, John?
You know, I'm still the same. It doesn't matter to me. You want to go one or two, that's...
I'm going to leave you a one.
You know, again,
I mean a two. I'm sorry.
I'm based on how I put my numbers, how I thought of it.
Okay.
You know, because I know when it comes up, we're going to buy it anyway, so it's a matter of...
You don't really have much of a choice the way Donna says it, or Mark said it's law. Okay, so the radios... Or two and two again. But I think it had something to do with the way people were applying the priorities. So you guys all good with that? Two.
What? Two.
John is a two. Donna's a two. I'm a one, and you're a one, and we're split. So it's a 1.5.
Well, Chris, why did you put a one there? Why did you propose a one?
You had to ask him that question.
Now you got me wondering about my own methodology now.
If I could connect to the internet, I could.
Well,
tell you
I was just.
Well, it's you can limp along with those.
They're not going to be out of.
Then no, we're not in the position of having them out of, you know, usefulness if we don't replace them.
Okay.
So
really,
I mean, yeah, the best way to do it is to kind of roll through them because they're expensive, so we try to keep them, keep the entire stock of them
fresh,
you know, within a certain age.
Wasn't there something by law we had to change them? What's that?
We went from analog from something.
Oh, that's no, there's
that's a long time ago.
There's reprogramming and things that have to be done with them, but whatever we're buying now, we'll keep pace with that.
Chris, you responded to I sent that email, your response was, suggest you view it as, oh, at that time. I think that's consistent with prior CIPs, and the fact that those items are listed in the future also speaks to their relative priority. I have to admit I read that wrong. I thought you said at this time, and that says at that time.
Okay.
So now in 2017, do we think that that radio mount is good?
We're on the CBAs, aren't we?
No, I think we went past the CBAs, didn't we? And we came up with one there.
You can't leave it at 1.5.
No, we came up with a one.
How did we come up with one? Did somebody change?
Yeah, you did.
I was already a one.
Hold it. Yeah. Yep, you were a one. Donna changed.
I changed on this.
Okay.
Sorry, dear.
All right.
You're a one now?
She's a one. She's a one-er. Now on the radios, where are we at, guys?
Stick with the two on that.
John?
1 pound with the two.
Okay. So we really are at a 1.5 there, unless Mark changes.
What is, remind me the urgency on the radios?
It's something we need to keep doing regularly, not necessarily in that moment will it need to happen.
Then it's a two.
Okay, so that's a two. Okay. Capital reserve funds at $11,000. There was some discussion over this. I was hoping to raise that back up, but there was reasons not to.
Well, wouldn't this be somewhat subject, the 11,000 on the subject of the purchase of a Quint if it gets approved?
Right.
If it doesn't get approved, will we default back to where we were last year?
Yes, we would.
We will, if that's the way the warrant article says.
You'd go back to 100 grand or whatever, yeah.
Well, I'm not writing the warrant article, but probably suggest that might be a good idea.
Yeah, I think it would probably be a separate or conditional.
I guess the.
Yeah, subsequent warrant article that.
Right. If such and such warrant article fails, then the capital reserve fund will go back to whatever.
Yeah.
But there's also a warrant article for the capital reserve, so. Okay.
I stand by my two.
Okay.
That was a two as well.
Okay, so that's going to be a two. That's a tour. And now we're on to highway, one-ton pickup with plow and sander for the year 21. I figure it was going to be a necessity in that year of purchase. So I'm a one, Mark's two.
You put it urgent in that year, I put it necessary.
I still think it's just too far out for us to know. That's why I went with four. I mean, it's 6 years out, 5 years out.
I'm looking at one-ton pickup with plow and sander. In 6 years, it's going
to
be a
piece of crap. So why don't we just compromise to a three on that one?
We could compromise to a two.
Why don't we compromise to a three? Because you're looking 6 years out. You know it's going to be desirable to change it out. You don't know exactly what shape the current one is going to be in.
I'm good with that, Mark.
Needed within 3 years to maintain basic level.
Yep. Yeah.
That's two. Desirable is needed within 4 to 6 years to improve quality or...
Right.
So in that spot, when we come to that time, it might be a one.
Yeah.
Or next year or the year after, it might change
right.
to a two.
See, I'm
looking. Because that's a living document here. Everything can, next year, these numbers can all be.
It absolutely is.
Put into a different way. So
absolutely.
Go
so,
to three.
I think the best sometimes is to be a little bit more broad than precise exactly on the ones or twos. Again, I'm going to restate the fact of because it sets the mindset of too much being urgent.
How come your numbers have italics? They're italicized.
Mine?
Are you special? Yeah, that's
I think we've got three threes on this.
How I printed on that.
It's a three. It's a three. I'm staying
three.
With my one. I don't. I've dealt with.
You're capturing all these, right?
Yes, I am.
I mean, Chris.
Okay, the 10-wheel dump truck, which is scheduled to be replaced in 2019.
But you can't just move on.
Why not, dear?
Because I think that the consensus here is it's a three.
It is a three.
Oh, but you're staying with your one. It
yeah,
doesn't
well,
matter anything.
Doesn't it's a three.
Doesn't
okay.
matter. This, these were
right.
just our opinions.
She's just holding tight to her
the
position.
The consensus is
three.
It's a three.
Okay. Then I'll turn my ears off.
Thank you. We're on to the 10-wheel dump truck. $250,000 in 2019.
I mean you can see for the next three line items I felt kind of
too far out.
Too far out.
Yeah.
So what number would you like there, girls and boys?
I would put them, to me, they're threes because they're desirable in that time frame, but not urgently needed, or we don't really know.
See, I look at my crystal ball and I see urgently needed.
Donna, you put premature on the grader. Was that because you were thinking about potentially the leasing thing or the contracting thing?
It just
thing?
Seemed too much too far out. I didn't overthink it. I'm happy to, I'll compromise to a three on those.
Are we all good with a three there?
Yeah.
And it's not—it's no reflection on the request. It's just too far out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Highway loaded with plow in the year 2020.
Where's that one?
Did I skip one?
No,
I didn't.
It's interesting. There's no number on it. There's no dollar amount on it.
Right. Yeah, that's a good point.
Was that because it was gonna? Why is that, Chris?
Why is that, Chris?
I don't know. Is it? does it fall off the end of the, that particular chart? 2023?
No, that's 2020, oh, was it? Was that the problem?
Yeah, we had it in for 2023 and not to carry this exercise that far out.
So do you, if you're gonna put it in...
It's outside of the CIP.
Yeah.
Okay.
That would make it five. It's in the chart.
Yeah.
That's good.
Is it because mine's not bold, you just think as highly of me as you guys?
I'm trying to figure all this out. I don't know, as we go.
Six?
Free and stuff.
Did we decide that that's a five?
Loaded with a plow? If it shows up in it, it will be a five? Is that good?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
I added it at a four, you know.
Stay focused. Shim and seal coat?
Nope.
Road construction, I'm sorry. My eyeballs are not following.
Looks like we already have three twos there.
So that's a tour?
Yep, same with the next one.
Jeep two, okay.
But I think those are, they are necessary, but they can be, you know, depending on what you're spending money on in other places.
Again, that budget could change too.
Yeah.
Well, it's an operating budget, so...
You're gonna, yeah, at some point, this board and the road agent are gonna have to have a really serious talk about how far behind are we on maintaining the roads? Because I think that he's getting further and further beyond.
That's why I put a one there, because we so often fall behind.
I mean, I think, to me it's a two for now, but then you have to have the serious sit-down strategy session.
Okay. Capital Reserve Fund, we're split. John and I are one on the Capital Reserve for $75,000. And Donna and Mark are at twos. What's your pleasure, people?
I put one because we have to put the money away.
Thank you. Good plan.
I put two because it would not be desirable not to put the money away, but if we had to not put it away, we could.
Yeah, that's why I put two. I put two as, yeah, it's necessary to put it away, but if you didn't put it away 1 year, is it going to kill anything? You can catch up the next year.
It's very short-sighted. I
know it is.
I worked with the budgets when we didn't have strong capital reserves, and it was awful.
I know.
I'm not saying it wouldn't be uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Wait, these are...
TBDs.
Okay, one or two. What's your pleasure, folks? 1.5.
For what? Capital reserve.
Capital reserves. We're at a 1.5.
Well, since we did the fire and rescue as a two, I think you'd do this one as a two.
Sure, yeah, well...
And since you did the police cruiser as a two, you'd do this one as a two.
Not me. You guys are the ones putting them into twos. Are you willing to back away, John, or hold your line?
Again, a one or two, that's
academic.
It's not going to make or break anything, whether we go one or two on there.
Two. He doesn't feel strongly enough to fight for one.
Okay. Okay, now we're getting into the recreation. I think that's a little bit more. Want to get rid of the library and the recycling center?
Yeah, I don't think we can talk about that until after we talk about Marston, really.
Oh, you really? Why is that? We can't talk about the library roof?
No, recreation.
I know.
Okay.
Might be a longer discussion.
Yeah.
So do you want to do the rest of them first?
Well, I'm saying I don't even believe that we can talk about recreation until after we talk about Marston.
Oh, I thought you were saying just the opposite.
No.
Okay, okay.
You're talking about Marston as the Board of Selectmen. You're talking about the CIP as the CIP.
I understand that.
Okay.
I understand that.
Okay, so the library roof. John and Donna didn't weigh in on that one?
Yeah, I skipped that one.
I missed
one. It wasn't on our, I don't know.
Would you, it's $30,000 for 2016.
Remind me again of the state of the roof, Chris.
It's rough.
I'd put a one.
Okay, one.
Okay, we're ones.
Police is less than one, library is a one.
Now, the recycling center facility to be discussed.
I added that back in because it had been on,
mm-hmm.
and then it got dropped off somehow.
Okay.
And I put it as premature because it still is a premature discussion.
Okay.
But I think it still needs to be on there because you've got a recycle facility that's built in 1972, so
right.
that building is really old. Now that, you know, obviously they've done everything they can with it, but that whole facility at some point, I mean, I think it's still, I think you're not talking about it until 2020 anyways. You know, I mean, it's pretty far out.
I'm glad it's in here. It'll
but
come up in the
you
next
don't,
discussion.
You don't want to, you don't want to, you want it there just to have the conversation.
Yep.
You know?
Okay. That's so what this is all about. That's what the CIP is supposed to do.
That's why I said it's premature. It's a five. But it, you know, you
want
to have it.
Do you want, we'll leave it at a five, folks?
Sure.
Yeah, okay. That's fine. Now the community center roof, the community center back building, that's to be discussed. Okay, let's do the roof. The community center roof is also rather urgent.
It's all ones, Mary.
Yes. Okay. I hadn't noticed. Community center back building.
I mean, I don't. It doesn't say anything. I don't know what it is. So
it's right here. It's this back building.
I know where it is, Mary.
Okay.
I don't know what's being proposed. Here.
Nothing at the moment. That's
right.
That's the
why
problem.
It's a five. Premature.
Okay. I put a two because we need to talk about something within the next 3 years because it's going to cave in around our heads, whether or not we want to take it down altogether. I mean, it really has to be a little higher than a three because it's a good space, maybe.
Well, I said premature because of the needs more research, planning, and coordination because it does need that.
Yep.
And that could occur this year, and then it could become a one or two next year.
I guess I'm a necessary needed within 3 years to maintain basic level. And we need to have that discussion within the next 3 years, not longer than that.
Well, we did have a building committee that I thought was discussing that, but I don't know.
Boy, it's
that
been discussed
to.
Ad nauseum, and nothing's ever
well,
been.
Well, we spent money on it a few years ago.
We don't really have a building committee anymore.
I know.
Maybe that's something that the new board wants to put in place.
Sure. You volunteering?
No.
Okay, community center back building. What's the consensus here, guys?
Yeah, I'll change to a two on that.
We have two twos. John, where are you?
You have three twos.
Am I on the wrong?
If I change to a two.
Whose else is a two?
Yeah, who else is a two?
Am I reading it wrong?
Five.
Mark and John.
I got a five. I was with you on that, Donna.
Which one are you on?
I don't know. Let me.
Community center back building.
Oh.
Oh, wait a minute.
Sorry,
wait a minute. Wait a minute.
I skipped ahead.
Community center back building. I had a three.
No, you had a two.
No.
John had a three.
I'm trying to remember. Yeah, go. John had a
three. It looks
like
it should actually fall, in my opinion, right now. After looking at what everybody wrote, I'd put four. Deferrable. Can't be placed on hold, you know, for another 6 years, or because we got to have a plan before we spend any money or do anything.
That's why I put a two.
So it's not, without a plan, there's no money being allocated or spent till we know what we're going to do.
You don't even have a dollar amount in there.
Exactly.
So what do you guys want?
How can it possibly be a two?
Exactly.
Right, because two's going to be more necessary if we put a...
So we're averaging between all of us a four. Four is fine.
All right. I'm staying with my two. Only because we've been putting it off and putting it off and putting it off. Community center back building. ETA, I think I missed this one. Nope, I didn't.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, you did.
Oh,
HVAC.
I did. Yeah, I know I missed one of them.
The CIP, yeah. This document, it will not reflect what we individually
yes,
voted
right.
for the,
not at all.
The
no.
book.
No.
Just to be clear that I didn't think it was going to. I'm just.
But the minutes will.
Sure.
community
Mary's
center.
Mary's going to handwrite her opinion in every single copy.
Exactly.
Or you might get a letter in the mail.
Or an email. Whatever.
On the HVAC, I can't actually think why I went four on that one. So I'm okay to go with two on that.
Okay, that's a two. Okay.
Yeah, within 3 years. That's why I put a two.
Yeah,
within 3 years, you're going to...
Okay, back up to recreation.
Yeah.
Now, we have to discuss it. Can we discuss it as a CIP before we discuss it as a Board of Selectmen?
I don't believe so.
Okay. So we're going to have to come out of the CIP, discuss it as a Board of Selectmen, and then go back into CIP?
If John's okay with that?
sure I'll sit for this one, absolutely.
Become a mushroom.
What a guy. So I need a motion to close the CIP and open the Board of Selectmen.
Do we close CIP or do we pause CIP?
Oh, sorry, pause, recess, you're right.
You can just do what you gotta do here, if John's here, do your piece.
John, you can sit up here.
I'll let you guys discuss, I'll sit in the audience and watch.
Okay.
I make a motion that we pause, that we...
Recess the CIP.
Okay, have got a second?
To a time certain.
Yeah, until the Board of Selectmen ends the discussion of the Marston tonight. Gotta say tonight.
I'll make a motion that we recess the CIP meeting to enable the Board of Selectmen to discuss Marston property, at which point we will reopen the CIP meeting.
Tonight. Second?
Yes, second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you. Now we have to...
Here.
Open the...
Nested meetings.
We have to open the Board of Selectmen's meeting. We've done this before.
I'll make a motion that we unrecess the Board of Selectmen's meeting.
Okay, second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, okay. We did something very similar to this when we were buying Mulligan Forest with the Budget Committee, didn't we? We had to close the Budget Committee meeting and open the Mulligan Forest. Oh, God. It was complicated. Okay, now we're gonna discuss the Marston Trails.
Marston property. So, Chet and Mishka are members of the committee. Feel free to come forward.
Help us.
Be part of the dialogue. I'll also introduce Fred Schaff, who has not been a member of the committee, but he is a Nottingham resident who has been helping us with some of the pricing. So the last time we met, we looked at diagrams, showed you diagrams, mm-hmm. right? And talked a little bit about the phase one project, which at the time was being laid out by Ironwood at being, you know, 440,000, so thereabouts, right? The Marston Property Committee met last week and said, you know, that we wanted to come up with, you know, we wanted that broken down into sub phases. What they were calling phase one, we were looking really for like phase 1A, phase 1B. And we wanted them to really sharpen their pencils and to come back and tell us what we could accomplish for the amount of 200,000. Okay? So, they came back, essentially we asked them to focus on the multi-use field, which also encompasses a softball field and a little league field, as well as the community gardens and the hiking trails. Adding those in because we felt like those would, you know, offer something for everybody in town. And we asked them to take a look at how we could do that for the amount of 200K. The thinking of the committee at the time was that we would take $80,000 from the Rec Revolving Fund, and the committee voted to request that the Board of Selectmen put forward a warrant article for $120,000 to begin the initial work. After the meeting, the Ironwood came back to us with their sharpened pencil, and it came in at $287,000. So they were not able to meet the number that we had asked them to meet. Fred, who works for, and the biggest thing is the earth moving, right? Because that's expensive. And so we asked, Fred has done quite a bit of work with Gary Cowan on fields in the past. Fred works for Severino. He gave us a complimentary set of numbers for moving earth as well. And they weren't that far. There was some savings in there compared to Ironwood, what Ironwood had put forward, but not enough to make us go, ooh, we can do this for significantly less, right? So basically, what I've done here is I've laid out and shared this with all of the members of the Marston Committee about, Chris Evelyn, you can get back to him, about essentially we have kind of like four options at this point. I'll give that to you since you guys. So the last thing that we want is for this to create a big tax burden. Last thing we want is for this to fail, right? And so we've laid out, you know, kind of four options. First is kind of proceed with the request for the warrant article of $120,000 to begin initial work as discussed at the meeting. I've laid out, these are kind of my personal pros and cons to each of these approaches. You know, it would help us get the project started and get us playing on fields in 2018. There's, when you're going with a seeded field, it takes time to get the field seeded and playable. We all know that we could use extra fields today. If we had extra fields today, they'd be in use full time. However, you know, the numbers that we're seeing are still, you know, this 120 plus the 80 wouldn't get us to where we need to be for that phase one. We're also very aware of the fact that if we put something forward at town meeting and it fails, then no means no, and you know we won't be able to do anything out there. Another thing that we discussed was instead to pursue bonding for this. Chris did some ballpark, you know, back of the envelope estimates and said if we were going to try to bond $440,000 for 5 years at 5%, we'd be looking at about $67,000 per year. That's more affordable.
Where did the 441 come from?
That was the
We must have taken something off the top to get to that, because that 5 times 67 doesn't equal 441, so we must be.
Was that just phase 1A, the 287?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, the 287.
So
okay.
So bonding the 287 turns into 441 over 5 years?
No, I'm sorry.
No.
The way that Ironwood had laid out their numbers were in year one, 287 does all the work, the earthwork, and gets you the fields, and in this second year, 96 gets you the community gardens and the hiking trails. Okay.
So that's the 287 and 91 is still less than 441.
Then there was a 57 contingency number in there, right? Chris, that was
yep.
The difference. Yeah.
What's the contingency number for?
You see any of the cost projections, you put in a contingency for things that go wrong or surprises that you find on the ground or
generally 10%.
Whatever. Yeah, it's a they were I think Ironwood had 15%, but it's
yeah. So that number, that math was based on doing just the 287, which would get us the fields. It's affordable. On the flip side, we're very tight to try to do something with bond in terms of the timeline. Not impossible, I don't think. We'd have to work it out with the budget committee in regards to their hearings. But it would also, you know, once you go out for a bond for 5 years, and I'm expressing my opinion, I'm going to let Chet talk to this as well. If you put a bond out for 5 years, that's all the town is going to be focused on doing for 5 years. And in 5 years, all we'll have is three fields. But Chet, do you want to talk about the bonding a little bit more?
Well, the only reason when Donna asked to prioritize, yeah, I looked at the bonding from the perspective of the 441. If you take the 441, back out the 80, which we would get from the rec, again, that's just all assumptions, using the assumptions. That would get us down to about 72.2 before interest per year over 5 years. You know, the other factors you get in there, there's, as discussed with John and the planning board last week, the potentially of the rec having part of the impact fees. Again, at their meeting, that was raised. Again, it's all proposals, so there's a possibility there. The other possibility is when the folks come in with their proposal, they had a whole shopping list of potential grants. And again, grants are speculative, but there's a possibility, until if you get something rolling, you put a bond out there, that this bond could be picked up in a number of other ways, other than straight taxpayers' money, was my thinking.
Yeah.
And it gets you the initial shot. My own sense is, if you ever got that 441, you got that thing going, probably take us 5 years before we'd ever get ready to you know, learn from it, experience from it, decide if we need more, expand it. So to me, it's not unreasonable, because we've been working on this for 2 years now.
Yeah.
And the fact is, I think we get overwhelmingly support from what all the open committee meetings and all the public, and Nottingham Day. We got unbelievable support, and if you look at the large number of kids, families, members, when you throw the garden in, you got some of the elderly, you got all population into this. So I just feel comfortable. That's my thought as to how to approach it, instead of piecemealing it. You're gonna end up with the same dollars over a long, long period of time, and it may cost you a lot more. Whereas if we get a fixed amount, say the 441. So anyway, that's without rambling on.
Yeah, I mean, and
that was just my two cents.
Grants, we've talked about grants. I mean, I'm of the belief, and I mean, I think you guys share it as well, that it's easier to get grants once you've got a project in motion and going. It's difficult to get grants to start breaking ground and moving earth. But once you're showing that you've got a viable project with community support behind it, then it's easier to get grants, and you're gonna get them in smaller chunks for different types of things, right? The other thing that Chet mentioned was the impact fees. I had a very good discussion at the planning board meeting the other night about impact fees. And what the planning board wants to do is, as we know, evaluate whether or not we should be charging impact fees for recreation.
How did that go?
Well, we're intending to move forward with the study with Bruce Mayberry to determine if we should be looking at recreation impact fees, but that is a separate
the way I thought that Bruce Mayberry was going to help us decide whether or not we were actually, was it feasible to continue to collect
two separate things. So one is it feasible with what we're doing currently,
right,
and then the third component of it, fire, school, right? Mm-hmm. Those two, evaluate those, if we should still continue to do those.
Okay.
And if we're still at the right fee level.
Exactly.
And then the third piece of it is, should we be looking at doing the same thing with recreation?
Can you do, if you're not collecting impact fees for fire and schools, can you collect recreation separately? Or does it have to all go together as a package?
No, I think you can do it separately, right? John?
The fee is broken up.
Yeah.
From a sum total, it's broken into three different ways of where it goes. Right now, 6,000. Don't hold me on these exact numbers. Six is going to the school. 800 and 6,800, I believe. 800 goes to the fire department, which is paying off the new fire department building. And then whether Bruce would need to see a plan for the rec department to show a just cause in order to put a amount to whether that number goes from 7,500 for, let's say, and that 700 goes to the rec fund or whatever you want to say.
Right, we talked about that.
Without that, this idea or plan, or even a motion that's set up by the board or the selectmen to go forward with this, then there really isn't much that Bruce is gonna say, because he can't build it hypothetically without having numbers and funds.
Right,
say
exactly. And
what
we,
he's gonna do.
And we talked about that, John, right?
I'm just reiterating.
Yeah,
I appreciate it.
But realistically, how much money are we talking about in impact fees? Because it's not a lot.
No, I think if you look at it as a $1 million fire station generated a $600 impact fee after all the studies and all that, so you could take, if the growth numbers all worked out the same, which they won't, they'll be smaller. If you took that same logic and applied it to the $440,000 here, you'd be looking at something less than a $300 recreation impact fee.
Yeah.
And the second piece with impact fees, you're right about using it to pay off debt, but if we were to move forward with a rec, if it all made sense, if the rec fee paid for the cost of the study to generate the rec impact fee, step one.
Yeah.
It would presumably be implemented in 2017 with a zoning ordinance change, right? That's got to go.
Well, it's got to go to town meeting if you're implementing.
Right. Okay, so that's 2017. Anything in the pipeline at the time of adoption is exempt from the impact fee. So every subdivision that we're aware of and is in any stage of the planning process is exempt. So you'd be looking at 17, you'd be looking at 18 before you collected anything, and it's probably not that many.
Yeah.
So it's going to be mice rice.
Who knows what subdivision development is going to be in, but it's not a...
It's not going to be significant.
Where we do believe we can benefit from some of the impact fees is the school right now has significant impact fee dollars.
Mm-hmm.
And we had a very good discussion with them about, you know, what their needs are for those funds. We talked about whether or not we believed that those funds could be used for, say, a softball field at Marston property. It was the opinion of most of the people on the planning board that it probably could be. So we're going to continue to pursue whether, in fact, that is an option as
the
well.
The only thing, the school district and the town are two different governmental entities. I'm not sure how you would get the money from the school into a town-owned project without somehow including...
I'm sure we can figure it out.
No, not necessarily. That's pretty...
I'm sure we can figure it out. Chris is sure we can figure it out. More importantly.
I don't know.
They will be used by the nine school programs.
Right.
If
right.
They'll be actually at an after school program. I mean, these are...
They are.
They're wearing Nottingham school nights on their shirts. It's a school program.
Yep.
Playing on those fields, there might be a way.
So how much
I think I would, rather than have mites, I'd want to have definites.
Well, we're still in the planning process.
How much potential is there?
Well, I'm going to go and talk to them Wednesday night. I was throwing out a number of like 30,000 to see, but they're going to have to decide on that.
What was that?
30,000 was kind of the number I was throwing out.
For what?
Coming from the school's impact fees.
Oh, okay, okay.
Let me go back to the option. So the third option was, you know, slowing down a little bit, using this year to establish an expendable trust fund, seed the fund with the rec revolving fund money, and then have a smaller request via warrant articles to kind of help us get to that halfway point. So if that request were about 40K, or maybe it's a little bit higher, maybe it's 50 or 60, it helps us get closer to that halfway point at least. Then gives us a vehicle for accepting donations, you know, eliminates any risk of no means no. And it, you know, it shows the town that we're committed to taking a more prudent approach to this. Gives us a little more time to look for funding for grants that might be out there for portions of it. Gives us a little more time to kind of evaluate the costs. The downside is that, you know, it delays at least a year the need for fields. And in a year or 2 years, the cost is going to be higher. So those are the downsides. And then the fourth option was just to kind of start very small with just community gardens and hiking trails. I asked Ironwood for a very ballpark estimate on that. Their ballpark was around 18K. Community garden walking fields, very affordable, could do it with just rec revolving fund money to get people exposed to the property. We could also do 3 and 4 together, right? Kind of get started with that. Start an expendable trust fund and then try to fund it, you know, through an additional request for, you know, 30, 40, whatever that number is.
It would give you an opportunity to get the town involved. Perhaps establish a GoFundMe site. Doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt.
If you get a few thousand, it's a few thousand.
You might get a couple thousand. I mean, Mishka, you had some thoughts on kind of what that 40 or 50,000 number might look like. You want to kind of share your thoughts on that?
Yeah, well, I was just looking at it and saying, you know, if the rec revolving fund was going to, you know, phase in sort of, or put in the 80,000, that we could do a warrant article for a matching amount that would bring us a lot closer to the 200,000 that is needed in order to start the phase one process and get this thing built. And like you said earlier, to get it enables us to accept donations from different areas, but it also gets the ball rolling to the point where people will see and get an interest in the property and see that there's progress going and want to participate and get involved with it. Plus, it'll give us some time to work out on you know, getting grants and getting other sources of income, be
volunteers.
Volunteers, all that kind of stuff. I mean, I know that, you know, from all the meetings that we've had in the last 2 years, that there are lots of people in town who are more than happy to volunteer in one way or another. And there's a lot of resources out there that we got even through Ironwood. They gave us a long list of opportunities to get, you know, funding or grants or some types of donations and things like that, so.
I would leave no rock unturned.
Yeah, I know, and let's just be honest about volunteers though, right? There's a lot of people who want to volunteer and will help, and I trust in that good spirit. However, there are things that have to be done professionally.
Yeah, I think there's a...
And the biggest thing that we're looking at right now, you know, the earth moving at this point, that has to be done professionally. Now,
absolutely.
Chris, you know, took a good look at Ironwood's estimate and said, okay, here are some things that the town can do.
Mm-hmm.
And that helped.
Isn't that nice?
As well.
Yeah, no,
right?
That's a good idea.
So it's not like...
It's a town piece of property.
Yeah, we're not going to break ground by having people out there with shovels trying to grade,
well, if we have,
you know,
to.
The space for the fields.
No, that's very good.
But yeah, so it's that we've got to get over that initial hump,
mm-hmm.
right? Once we get over that initial hump, then I think getting the grants and outside funding is going to be easier, and then getting the volunteer work is you know, labor is going to be easier. But it's that initial expensive part, right?
I think I like the idea of starting at three myself and going through to four, and then have a better presentation and be ready ahead of time for any bonding kind of thing, personally. How do you feel, Mark? We're all friends here.
No, we're not. let's not do it there.
Let's pretend we are.
Well, I'd like to find a way to fund the whole goddamn thing, but yeah. Given other information that I have, I can't see moving on it. I'm sorry.
Moving on it at all?
I'm
not picking. There's no right or wrong answer. I'm just trying to understand.
It's frustrating as hell because this is a really, really, really important project for the town.
I don't think it hurts to begin the process at all. I don't think that hurts at all.
Yeah.
I think, you know, my initial thinking was, my thinking last week at our meeting was, let's put a warrant article for it, and let's get this puppy going, right? My gut says, let's go with option number three, right? And
do you like to integrate four at the same time?
Yeah,
okay.
I think so.
Okay.
And
I think the most important thing that needs to be focused on are the ball fields. I think that if you tried to integrate four, you're really taking the focus off where things need to be. There's plenty of other places in this town to go hiking.
Yeah, good point.
And the community garden, you know what? I would view that as something that you do later on. I think that you should take anything that the town will allow you to do, focus it on those fields and get them up as soon as you can.
I think Michigan had a comment.
I totally agree with Mark in the sense that I think that the meetings, the town meetings that we had that talked about trails and talked about the community gardens. One, we have, I think, an Eagle Scout is currently redoing the trails here and redoing all the signage, so that's a big Eagle Scout project. The proposal that Ironwood came forth to us with had a bunch of things listed in there that were key items for our future Eagle Scouts that are in town, which we have quite a few scouts that are following that route, so that's exciting for them. I think that it's definitely a, you know, something that there's no, there's, we haven't seen any ownership either from anybody regarding, even though they've mentioned the town, the veg, you know, the community gardens. There was a mention of it. I think that we need to put some more feelers out there to find out who's going to take leadership and the responsibility on all that.
Responsibility for maintaining it, otherwise it just becomes a...
Because somebody needs to be in charge of it. And so I think that, you know, step four should be waited on only because we need to put, either it's a Marston Property Community Fields Committee or whatever, but somebody needs to be in charge of it and manage it and control who's got what plots and that kind of stuff, and who's used, you know, who's got access to the shed and the tools and the water and everything else.
I'm happy. I think starting with the trust fund is the right thing to do this year. Mm-hmm. I like what you just suggested, Mary, that it also gives us a little more time, so maybe next year we are looking at a bond for, you know,
and we have our funding set up,
that we have time to think it through.
Time to figure it out.
Yeah, I like the, if we come into the town with a good project, a good plan, we need this much, but we've already accomplished this much in funding and in some work.
Can you take more from the rec revolving fund?
It's at like 140.
Yeah, we're gonna close 15 at around 160, I think we said.
Seriously?
So why don't you?
We spent 20.
We
want to hold.
That's right too.
Or it was 25. We wanted to hold 30 to revolve and act like a revolving fund. So
right. We felt that that was tight.
So then
though.
You got 100.
Got 100, 110.
Well, you said you were going to end at 100. What'd you say? 160.
160.
Minus the 20, minus...
That's 140.
Then we got to keep 50 in there?
110.
Did we say 50 in there or 30?
I think we hadn't set a hard number. The committee came back and said 16. And you all said that's too tight.
Yeah.
I think
30 to 35 is it?
Double it, 30, 35. I think you got the money that you need to flex there.
Okay.
And take the rest of it and move it over.
Okay.
So that would be moving...
100.
100.
That should...
But I also think that we should raise the warrant article request from 40,000 to maybe even to doubling it, to matching the if we leave the rec revolving fund to 80,000 to match the 80,000.
Well, how about if you did this? How about if you put 100 from the rec revolving fund and you say, you go to town meeting, you say, we've already started this expandable trust fund. We've got $100,000 in it, right?
Well, we have to have approval from town meeting.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. But hear me out. So you got $100,000 you seeded it with. You're asking the town to double it so you can get going.
To match it so we can go.
So you can match it so you can get going.
It's still not the, now, the 287 that they needed. So
well, it was 200. Somebody was saying earlier with 200 you could get going.
Right.
Okay.
Right? And then the next phase is you look at bonding and outside funding.
Exactly.
Right?
Yep.
And I know, I said this the other night, that I know that there's a bank, I mean, my bank.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I know there's other banks that, you know, they'll put $5,000 or $10,000 into something.
How nice.
But again, that's something that we as the Marston Property Committee, we were tasked with trying to figure out what the best use for the property is.
Right.
Now we need to start almost with a new group
we
need to source these revenue options that you're talking about.
A building committee and a fundraising committee.
Absolutely.
So we need two new committees. So Mary, are you supportive of moving 100K from the rec revolving fund into this new fund and asking the town via warrant article to match it with another 100K?
Yeah.
And you're okay with that?
Well, I'm going to go against a campaign promise that I made, and I have to tell you that again, MPEC to me was and is the most important new project in the town. There is some big money being spent in other places, big money, and it all comes out of the same pool, and I'm really, really concerned about it. But that said, I will support that.
Yeah, I think your concerns are understandable. I mean, things are a little iffy right now, economically, worldwide.
I'm not talking worldwide, I'm talking just...
No, I'm talking, I am.
Okay.
I'm so scared as shit.
Yeah.
It's not funny, I mean, it's...
Okay, but anyway, so all in agreement...
We didn't identify, the one part that makes that hard, it's, we did not identify a path where $200,000 in this year gets us playing in 2018, did we?
No. We're still...
But it's a very good start.
Yeah, no, we were just being very conscious of day one on the field.
Yeah.
And trying to get that as quickly as possible.
So maybe...
Right, but that's 85% of that line.
Right.
Yeah.
Once you get that ball rolling, like Mark said, once you get that ball rolling, and you're building a project, it'll be much easier to acquire grants.
Yeah.
Raise funds.
Right.
Well, and I think, like...
And you'll get to...
Can you just build one field?
I'm not endorsing any particular vendor or anything like this, but in having discussions with Fred, who works for Severino,
mm-hmm.
they're doing quite a bit of work in town.
Mm-hmm.
And so there may be opportunities where they can leverage equipment and resources that they have in town on other projects,
right.
that they may be able to reevaluate some of their costs and help us start
Also, there's been the offer of the town highway department to help too. So that, I mean, you can come up with that $87,000 probably
in savings or exactly.
Pretty quick.
Yes.
Now, what we're talking about.
I'll tell you, there's another thing that y'all could do.
Mm-hmm.
How much is going into the general fund from the cable franchise fees?
40.
You could do another warrant that for the next X number of years, any overage in the cable franchise fees goes into this fund.
I've always suggested that you keep your spending decisions separate from your revenue decisions. We had talked about other vehicles like that where you kind of fall into money.
Yep.
You can always find a way to do it, but I think it's probably better to keep your, is it worth spending this much money, yes or no, and let that decision stand on its own.
Yeah, but my point is the cable franchise fund is fully funded at its $30,000.
Yeah, but what you're doing, the flip side of what you're doing there is you're going to set up a competition between using it for cable related stuff.
No.
And rec related stuff.
No.
Yeah, because any money that you spend on cable related stuff has to be refilled the way you have it set up now. So it may not come to this, but what you're doing is say, do we spend this on a TV camera or on third base?
I think that's the
overage is good.
I think actually that's a good conversation to have. I really think that would be a good conversation.
It looks
to have.
Like you're rating a lot of different funds in the town when you start doing that. I'm not sure how that's going to be perceived.
Okay.
So just to answer your question, the change that we made last year was we get these cable franchise fees coming in from Comcast, right? Anybody that's a subscriber pays into it and it comes in. And the change that we made last year was we put a cap on the size of the cable franchise fund that will hold for doing video equipment expansion. The school uses it and we use it. It turns out that the things that we've done here over the last few years is pretty much what we needed to get done. Right. So there's like $30,000 sitting there, and the school can use it to upgrade and expand, and they have actually,
right.
I think they've taken about $10,000 off of it. Anything... Once the fund is fully funded at $30,000, any dollars that come in get put into the general fund. They get put into unallocated space. Okay. So they're there for us to use for other things.
Reduce the taxes.
The mechanism though is once somebody takes, if somebody spent $10,000 out of that fund, the priority is you got to fill that fund back up.
Right.
You got to fill it back up because you got to be ready for the next thing, right?
Yeah. But I think your point was
if it's at 30 and all that, instead of kicking it into the general fund, why not kick it into the...
Is that a decision that can be made at the time when you're evaluating? There comes a point where you're saying, we've got money in the cable franchise fund. Is that a decision that the Board of Selectmen can make, for example?
I think that was voted in by town, wasn't it?
No, we have not worked out whether our auditor, when we're gonna say, I think we're gonna, what we'll use is our year-end numbers. Our audited numbers, we will set up so that the December 31 balance on the cable franchise fund is 30,000, and everything else will fall to the... undesignated fund balance.
Does the Board of Selectmen have any mechanism at that point in time to say?
No.
Okay.
No, you can't touch the undesignated or the unassigned fund balance without town meeting.
Yeah.
And town meeting has told you this is what to do with that money, so that's what we...
Question about the expendable trust fund. So if we have set up an expendable trust fund and someone wants to donate, you know, Chet decides he has too much money in his retirement and he wants to donate money to the project, can donations be put into an expendable trust fund?
Yeah, I have to do a little more homework on what we'll need town meeting to authorize. I think we have a standing ancient blessing from town meeting that you can accept donations for things. It's how strictly it can be designated that I have to do the homework on. The reason that we were thinking of expendable trust fund rather than a capital reserve fund is so that you can have an agent to make a spending decision in between town meetings.
Right.
The Rec Revolving Committee had come to you and said we should make this a capital. We take that money and put it in a capital reserve fund so that town meeting is making the decision.
Yep.
What you're talking about now is to basically keep that spending decision but have town meeting tell you this is the ballpark that we want to spend it in, not recreation broadly, but and so just so that we're all clear why we were talking about that particular vehicle is so, because we're in this flux. Obviously we have things to figure out and we may have things in year one that we want to jump on. We don't want to wait until town meeting 2017 to jump, so that's why expendable trust fund rather than capital reserve fund.
I almost think that you it's going to have a special warrant article for the MPEC committee, the whatever, to accept gifts of money and donations separately.
It's probably going to need something from town meeting, which is pretty straightforward. But
Mary, do you need any kind of a motion on this?
There's going to be I think it's going to show as a warrant article when Chris finishes the warrant.
Okay.
And when we vote to accept the warrant.
That will be sufficient.
Yeah.
Okay. You guys have any other comments you want to share on that?
No, I'm just excited to be able to move forward with the project, and I know that a lot of people are showing enthusiasm, so hopefully we can lead them all down the right path.
Yeah.
Are you three comfortable with me raising this with the budget committee on Thursday? Say this is coming. This is we're at 100 and 100. We're working out the details, but okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, as always, I always have to thank the committee for doing such great work on this. It's been 2 years. It's been slugfest at some points, but it's been very good work. I want to thank Fred for over the weekend helping us to work through some of the numbers, and I want to thank both of you for supporting us tonight.
Well, thank you very much for all of that you've done. You've kind of spearheaded this thing.
Absolutely.
It hasn't died on the vine.
Nope.
When I talked to you,
working a tail off
before you ran, I told you.
Spearhead. Yeah,
it's important. You know, it's important.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you
very much.
Thanks, guys.
Have a good night. Wait a minute, we know what we're going to ask for in the short term on the CIP. Do you know what you're going to ask for in the long term before we get out of here?
So we kind of took this is just Chris and I kind of doing
some
ballpark stuff.
We're recessing the Board of Selectmen meeting.
In the first year it's going to be the ball fields, right?
Okay, let me see where we are.
Suggest that you recess the Selectmen's meeting and open the CIP?
Yeah, well, no, I think it's premature because the Board of Selectmen has to... No, I know. The Board of Selectmen has to approve or request what's going into the CIP. That's what I'm trying to do right now. What exactly are we going to ask the CIP to
two slots.
Evaluate?
You know what I mean?
I might differ with that interpretation, but you go right ahead, we'll get where we need to get.
Well, what I'm saying is, we make out a form saying what we want, the Board of Selectmen makes out their request to the CIP. That's what we're doing right now, we're making out our request, what we want to give to the CIP.
We'll get where we need to get, you go whatever process you wanna go.
Does anybody agree with that?
I have no idea what you just said.
I wasn't listening to you.
Well, every department in town puts a request to the CIP committee.
Oh, so you're saying the BOS has to come up with its request to present to the CIP?
Yes, which is what we're doing right now.
That's fine.
Okay.
All right, so again, Chris and I kinda looked at that, this, and it would be like, the first year would be the multi-use field, the softball field, and the baseball field.
So, is that designated accurately in our form?
The multi-purpose athletic field, yeah, that's fine. Well, multi-purpose athletic field and the two ball fields.
So they'll be different, okay, so let's do the multi-purpose athletic field, what year?
So, I would say 2017.
And that would be for?
Well, put it together if you're gonna do it that way then, because it's really the multi-purpose field, the softball field, and the baseball little league field at the 287 in 2017.
So
you got the first one and the fourth one.
Combined?
Sorry, the second one and the fourth one combined.
Yeah.
Okay, so that, and that will be in 2017. And the amount would be, go ahead.
That would be the 287, right, Chris?
It's the best we're gonna do today.
It's the best we're gonna do.
Okay, okay.
Yep.
That's all we need is a.
There's not 25?
25.
Yeah, and again, I don't have numbers for the rest of it, but the way that the rest of it, like I'd leave the walking trails for, say, 2018.
Hold on. Okay, and what's the
figure that? So I would put the walking trails and the community garden for 2018. And
at what amount?
You could put that in at the 18, but I would cross out and well.
You don't need the well, right?
Okay, Marston walking.
Well, actually, no, you would need the well.
If you're gonna have a garden,
yeah.
You don't need the well.
Do you need the well for the athletic fields to water them?
Not the first year.
Okay.
No, this is a seeded, not a sod.
Yeah.
So we're not, these numbers don't have irrigation in them.
So irrigation comes later?
It can.
It can, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, the kind of the way.
If you seed it, it's not as dire.
We had kind of talked about it was 2017, you're doing these fields, right?
Right.
Then 2018, potentially you're doing a pavilion, a well, and irrigation.
So we need to change this.
Yeah, but the problem is I don't have numbers for these.
Yeah. But you don't have to.
Okay, so
just make a number. 100,000. Wow. It just has to have a number.
So these would be the categories. Pavilion, well, irrigation would be in the second year. A bigger ball field in the next year, and then basketball and tennis courts in the next year.
You got that?
No. Pavilion.
You're gonna do it one year apart for each one of these?
I don't know yet. You know, honestly.
This is a living
document. Space it out a little more.
It's a living document.
Space it 2 years.
2 years each. That's fine.
Make it every 2 years.
Every 2 years, that's fine.
Doing freaking people out.
Put the community well, the gardens, and the community gardens, the hiking trails, and the well in the next year, though, Chris.
2018?
Yeah, and then do 2 years from there out.
Do you have a ballpark idea of number?
Hang on, you guys really set on those community gardens and the walking trails. I think that's the least and most important thing of this whole project. The fact that we live in a rural town, the fact that we don't have condo developments where people would need gardens, the fact, I'm just expressing my opinion on it, just to voice it out there.
I think that the places that we have to go hiking are difficult to get to and to park.
But really not hiking, there's walking trails. It's like walking down a street or walking down a dirt road. It's really just a, there's nothing.
Mulligan is wonderful. Mulligan has great trails.
I think those trails will turn into cross-country skiing trails.
They do. Makes it easier to walk.
Yeah. Again, put it down. It could change.
Right, I guess right.
That's exactly right.
I will say, you may be surprised at this, I will say that I'm intrigued with the possibility of a community garden. I just don't understand how it would work yet. You know, but I am intrigued by that.
You need to have somebody who owns it.
Yeah, there's an ownership thing there.
But I am intrigued by the idea of it, because it's different. And it would produce something, and it would be an opportunity for people to learn, who wanted to participate, to learn something that's not athletics, you know?
You know what I think you should do?
If you made it educational.
You made it educational.
Where you said on Saturday, somebody who's gonna run it would actually have it on how to properly plant, how to properly cultivate, how to properly do things.
You know, and...
But if you just have a regular, people get a 4x4 spot.
There's a whole discipline called...
Their weeds are getting into my kind?
There's a whole discipline called permaculture.
Yeah.
And that would be a very interesting place to do some kind of permaculture stuff. You know, but anyways, I'm digressing, but...
A university involved, I would check with other communities to see if they're having successful community gardens.
Let's first see if we get the ball fields going.
I love it.
Who's the lady that does the Grow Green lady on...
Oh, I love her. Oh, yeah, she's wonderful.
I know somebody who's got a...
Are you good enough?
No, but,
I can come up and spend some time with you.
What's, if you're willing to give me a little bit of flexibility on the years and the dollar amounts, if I could just get your relative priorities for multipurpose ball field, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
That looks like it's a 3 across the board for us.
On the multipurpose athletic field?
As just described, what we're calling phase 1.
Yeah, that looked like a 3 pretty much.
Three?
Yeah, I think 3s.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then a couple of years later, we talk about the garden and the well.
And the walking trails.
And the trails.
Watch this.
And that's a 3.
I actually think they're all 1s, Mary.
I thought you hadn't had dinner yet.
I know, you're gonna get hypoglycemic or something.
No, wait, no, Don, you gotta do this. So what were you gonna put on there, 3? Okay, I'm gonna stick with my 1.
So we said a year after that, the garden, the well, and the trails is a 3.
Right.
2 years after that, the pavilion and the irrigation is a...
3, 4. So far out.
Yeah, it's far out. The interesting thing about, once we get the pavilion and the well in, we can start renting and producing income. Right?
Yeah.
And by that point, we should be able to start hosting tournaments.
We're gonna need bathrooms by then.
And make money off of the tournaments as well.
You can rent space?
I know we can, but at some point...
Are we restricted from renting any space by the...
No, we just can't.
As long as it's public use, we can still rent.
And the town's in charge. And I don't think there's any...
A user fee, it's not a rental income.
What else did you need, Chris?
I think I got enough. I'm gonna send you all this before we publish it anyway, so you can have one last.
I think that when you all take this town meeting, you ought to do some projections into, once we get this thing built out, it can be somewhat self-sustaining.
Can we have a...
It's not gonna be fully self-sustaining, but show the fact that it can generate some revenue.
Correct, yes. Are you planning on doing a presentation at town meeting?
Yes, yes. I also think that it's important to have a couple of information sessions before town meeting.
Okay, yeah. Because town meeting's coming quick.
Yes, exactly. It may be just a Sunday afternoon at the library or...
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, something like that.
Okay. Okay, thank you very much, Don.
I make a motion that we recess the Board of Selectmen meeting and unrecess the CIP meeting.
All together, eh?
Yeah.
Mark?
What? Yeah, we missed what the flip...
We're just opening up the CIP again to finish the CIP.
And they're gonna ask the CIP to...
Sorry, Don.
Can I have a second?
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We got it. Okay. So...
I make a motion that we update the CIP based on the conversation just held in the Board of Selectmen's meeting.
Well, let's have John weigh in on that. Were you with us on those numbers?
Sure. I thought we were in a CIP meeting. I thought you guys were embedded proper and put us in a CIP meeting before.
No, we had to actually have a presentation to give to the CIP. It's kind of a little complicated.
All right.
But we just went through the numbers of putting the 2s and 3s.
I make a motion that the CIP...
We were ignoring you.
Be, let's
adjourn?
Wait, before you adjourn the CIP.
Okay, I think we should probably adopt the whole thing.
This is essentially what you have published in the annual report, this basically one page. Is there anything else you want alongside this with it, anything?
There used to be a write-up.
CIP report.
There was a CIP report.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who's gonna write it up. And I'm not I'm not looking at you. I'm not suggesting that you write it up. I'm not looking at you.
We didn't really have a chair of the CIP committee, did we?
Well, we did, but...
Is he not here tonight?
No.
You're looking at her.
Oh, no.
Yeah, you kind of have been the chair.
So. I used to do the CIP report, actually. I can go through it and see if I can come up with something. I mean...
That'd be great.
She's actually going to do some writing.
She did. Did she just say
she's going to do some writing?
And the meeting's being recorded.
Holy crap.
I'll look at it.
I might change my mind.
Why, you want to do it?
No.
Okay.
Can I make a motion that we adjourn the CIP meeting?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Thank you. All right.
Now you're going back to the Selectman meeting?
Now we're back to Selectman's meeting.
Thanks, John.
Woo! We've been through the twilight zone.
Yeah. It's always fun. I enjoy coming.
Let's do this.
Now we're back.
Now I'm getting hungry. Let's do this.
Okay. What else is left? Oh, that one last thing.
What one last thing?
I have a couple signatures and
a resignation.
No.
Wanna do that dead last? Is that what you're
Are we doing board reports and
I think we should do board report. I think we should do that piece last.
Okay.
I need the report on to you guys.
Okay.
Okay.
You have some mail.
You want this one now?
Sure.
If you're up for it.
I'll make a motion that the Board of Selectmen appoint Dirk Grotenhaus as the Commissioner of the Stratford Regional Planning Commission to a term ending February 1st, 2020.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 And there's a couple of wage increases.
Okay.
I think you need to sign that thing for Dirk.
Oh, I do?
On the second page there. Is there a chair signature
by George,
thing?
There is.
Yep.
January 18th?
Yes.
16. So I've been doing so good with the, so far so good with the 16.
Well done.
Is this retro for that individual? So you're going to go back all the way?
Back to the date of the, we did the whole group of them. Yep. We did them in mass, and then we'll be on anniversary date for everybody up there from here out.
Okay, and is he aware of it?
Yeah, we did it. I don't have his signed copy, but he and I sat down Thursday or Friday.
Okay. I'm glad that's done.
Okay. We have a resignation from one of the board members. Care to speak to it?
I think we should talk about...
We need to do our committee reports.
Committee reports first.
Committee reports? This was not on the agenda.
I know, but...
Yes, it is.
I didn't see an agenda. Was there really an agenda sent?
Yeah. Yeah, it was.
Okay. All right. Sorry about that. I apologize.
You all may change... We all may decide to change our minds. So, just let me talk about the budget meeting.
Okay.
The school public hearing was held last Thursday. The increase in the operating budget is about 2%, somewhere around $260,000. The tax effort is an estimated increase between 7.5% and 8%, depending on the result of the warrants.
I made some mistakes. I made the mistake of pointing out that the dollar amount rise, from 2014 to 2016. I'm not gonna share it here because we're not in a budget meeting and it's school money, whatever. It's significant. And I made the mistake of pointing that out. It wasn't gonna be pointed out. I pointed it out because it's big. Then I made the further mistake of acknowledging that that it's okay, that this was a big mistake on my part. I acknowledge the animosity that's directed in my direction. Okay. And it was a poor attempt on my part to offer an olive branch. Knowing that I'm leaving, I was trying to say, you know, it's okay. You know, we're all part of it, whatever. It was really bad. I shouldn't have gone there. I made the further mistake of using the term misleading on a spreadsheet that was given to us, that shows percentage increases in tax efforts, but it did not take into account the impact of revaluations. So I was saying it's misleading. So I made that further mistake. So then I was called on the carpet, attacked. Maybe that's too harsh a word, for the decision regarding the Mack truck. I didn't bother to explain that the money was already in the capital reserve fund. It just wasn't going to be of anything productive. And then I was accused of changing minutes regarding support of the quote-unquote $800,000 truck. I denied it and re-explained that I stated I was on the fence, which I did at that meeting, and that the Board of Selectmen had not voted on it, which it had not. We had not seen anything from the chief. And I let the person know who was accusing me of that they could go back to the video record if they wanted to. At that point, I thought it was more productive for me to leave the meeting than to allow what had turned into a pretty uncomfortable situation, I think, for everybody. So I quietly got up and left, okay? Because what was in my mind was, okay, there's a tie now to the Quint, and the chief hasn't even had a chance to get up and talk about it. We had a very good meeting about it here. I don't want to screw up. I don't want my presence to screw up his ability or your ability to objectively present something. So that's kind of why I was like, I'm just gonna, you know. So the board didn't have any votes. If you look at the votes that they took, I don't even know what they voted. I had left, and it was all for me. It was you gotta understand, it was all okay. I get it, and it's all, it really is okay. I mean, it is what it is. But if I look back and I analyze it, I just wonder if it's even productive for me to be at budget meetings going forward. I think that I've kind of become a bit of a lightning rod, and I certainly don't want to hurt Board of Selectmen or the town's efforts by being that lightning rod. I'd rather you all be in a position to have a productive meeting. So my personal view is, not that I won't go if you all wanted me to go, but I don't think it's gonna be very good if I go.
So you're resigning from the budget committee as well, or asking to be replaced, but?
Well, I'm just saying, you know, you got two motions in front of you.
Okay, hold on.
You all may decide to do the first motion and not the second motion. You know, whatever. However you guys want to do it. And I'm not actually quite sure.
Well, I don't think we should be a two-person board.
what we can do is we can accept Mark's resignation and appoint, we can appoint a person to fill his seat for the duration of his, until a new person is elected to that position.
Yeah. I'm not comfortable doing that.
Okay.
Just because I think to bring someone in for what's essentially going to be 2 months.
It's a very few meetings, actually.
Is difficult. And, you know, particularly if it was someone who was potentially running for the seat, it would give them an unfair
advantage. You could maybe contact the ex-selectman.
Absolutely. That's the other other choice we have.
The challenge, though, is that then you're bringing in someone who hasn't been a part of all of the discussion.
A breath of fresh air?
Well, yeah, but how much influence, how much can someone impact in this amount of time?
So what are you suggesting?
Well, I mean, I'm okay with the two motions. I don't know how many budget committee meetings there are that are left.
Yeah. There's the
Well, they're important ones. It's the town ones. They're important ones.
The town final review, which is this Thursday, and then
two important ones.
And then the town public hearing on February 4th. So we would have to accept Mark's resignation, appoint him for the rest of your term, and then appoint somebody else to the budget committee.
No, not for the rest of his term.
For the rest of this year.
Yeah.
I just want to be honest with you guys that you put me in a budget meeting, and I'm really not thinking about me right now. I'm not. You know, I quietly walked out of that meeting, and I think I'm more polarizing than you are, Mary.
And congratulations.
You're welcome.
What's your preference, Mary?
Well, I think we have to accept Mark's resignation, and so that goes without saying that we're going to accept Mark's resignation. So that's the first order of
business. Are you comfortable with us being a two-person board?
Well, he's saying that so you have to do it in order. Accept the resignation, then appoint him.
I understand that process.
I have no problem with being a two-person board.
Okay.
But what does Mark feel like? If we reappointed you till March, whatever.
If you reappoint me till March, whatever, I'll tell you exactly what I'm going to do.
Mm-hmm.
I will participate to the extent that I can.
Mm-hmm.
I'm resigning because I've got tremendous pressure in my professional life. That will take precedence over anything in the town. I tell you, in the past 3 years, it has not. I actually have moved things around for the town.
We've worked.
We've
worked around each other's schedules.
Yeah,
very
but
well,
I you know, even last week, I was supposed to be in Tampa last week on Thursday.
I could have gone.
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I was supposed to be in Tampa, and I moved that out to February.
Okay.
Because I could.
So,
you know,
what are you saying?
I don't know. I want to be here to help with Chris's review. You know, that's a priority for me.
Okay.
You know, the rest of it, you know, I'll do what I can. If I'm around and I can participate, I'll do it.
Okay, well, let's just start with, we can get into the appointment of someone on the budget committee after we've done all this other stuff. So we have a resignation here, and so we'll have to make a motion to accept the resignation of Mark Carpenter and declare the seat vacant. That, I think that's the first one we have to do.
All right, I'll move that the Board of Selectmen accept the resignation of Selectman Mark Carpenter and declare the seat vacant. The position shall be posted for the election on the March 9, 2016 town meeting for the remainder of the term ending in 2018.
I guess I'll second that.
Mm-hmm.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so that takes care of that one thing. You're officially resigned. Yay! Now, is there a motion to appoint Mark Carpenter to fill the vacancy until the election is held and a new selectman elected. Is that how it would go?
I'll move that the Board of Selectmen appoint Mark Carpenter to the position of selectman for a term ending upon the election and qualification of his successor.
That the Board of Selectmen appoint Mark Carpenter. Do we have to say anything about vacancy or anything?
Okay, so.
Second. I'll second that. All in favor?
Aye.
So you're reappointed. And now we have to discuss what we're going to do about Budget Committee. I guess I'm the man to go on Budget Committee.
Yeah, I mean, or we can
split it.
We can split it.
Well, that'd be fine.
I think, honestly, if you want to have your best shot, the person that comes the Budget Committee is Donna.
That'd be fine.
And I think that this Thursday's meeting is really important.
Okay. You want to?
They're going to talk about. They're going to be doing rec.
Well, it's the final presentation.
But rec has never gone in yet, right?
Rec's the only department that they wanted to see, so yeah. That'll be.
But we would all be there Thursday night anyway.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. So you'll sit for Mark.
Sure, I'll sit for Mark on Thursday.
Okay.
Night.
Okay.
So when is the chief going to present the quint?
Thursday.
Okay.
Have we done all our business now?
Yes.
Yay. Motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Are you still hungry?
Yeah.
Good night, folks.
I made these.